What is going on, guys? Fresh Brooks here, and today I'm going to be ranking every 1999 set with the, I guess it's the 20th anniversary of LEGO. Well, it is the 20th anniversary of LEGO, but it kind of already passed. But today I'm gonna rank all of these sets. But anyway, let's get started. So anyway, first one we have here is 7101 Lightsaber Duel. This is a pretty cool set. For $6, it's an amazing set. Has the main protagonist and the main aunt and I don't know how to pronounce it so early. But antagonist. So it has the main protagonist and the main antagonist, and then you've got a mini build. And in my opinion, 10 out of 10 on this set. It's pretty good. I mean, it is good, but yeah, I really like the build that Darth Maul's riding on, and yeah, that's pretty cool. Next up here, we have 7110 Land Speeder. This, I forgot to zoom in on the last picture, but this is a pretty cool set. I know for 1999, they didn't really detail it that much, but I don't really like the detailing on this one. It's all like tan, and his was kind of dark tan. So this one is going to get, you get two great minifigures, but this one has to get a 9 out of 10 just because the coloring is not good. But yeah. Next up here, we have Droid Fighter. This, in my opinion, is a terrible set. Number one, it's a terrible, LEGO version of the droid fighter. You get no minifigures. Like, you could have got a droid or something, like, just to go along with it. But, yeah, just don't really like this set. Don't really like the droid fighter. For that, I'm gonna have to give it, maybe a 8 out of 10. But, no, I'm gonna give it a, I'm not good at ranking stuff, but you guys can rank that for me in the comments, please. If you had to rank that one, which one would you rank it? Definitely not a good set. I don't know if I would rank it 5 out of 10, 8 out of 10. But, yeah. Next up here, we have Naboo Swamp. You get Jar Jar Binks. You get Qui-Gon Jinn. You get two droids. Amazing set. Automatic 10 out of 10. Next down here, we have Speeder Bikes. You have two... oh, my God. I forget what they're called. Scout Troopers, and you have Luke Skywalker. It would have been nice if they would have added a Leia minifigure, because she was in the scene where they were riding the land speeders. But other than that, I mean, I give it like a 9 out of 10 just because, I mean, just a 9 out of 10 because the side build doesn't look that good. But anyway, 9 out of 10 for that one. Next up here, we have a Snow Speeder. Automatic 10 out of 10. The Snow Speeder is an amazing ship. You get two minifigures. What better can you ask for? Then down here, we have Anakin's Pod Racer. Really like the Pod Racer scene in a Phantom Menace. So this is a 10 out of 10. You get the Pit Droid. You get Padme. You get a flag. You get Anakin. This is pretty good. I mean, the stand, the tan thing that holds it all together isn't really that good, but they didn't have clear pieces back then, so yeah. Next up here, we have X-Wing Fighter. I really like the X-Wing, but this model just isn't really that good. Again, it was 1999 at the time, so they didn't really have, they had like a little bit of a limit to go to, but again, this is not like a good set, so you get good minifigures, so I'll give it a 9 out of 10. Next up here, we have Naboo Fighter. This is pretty much the only 1999 set I have, and I really like it, except those stick pieces that is like on the very back of the fighter and the ones that are on the wings. Every time I like hit them with something, it breaks. Like, maybe if I was doing a review and I accidentally hit them, it would break right off. So that's like a little bit of a flaw. So yeah, I like the minifigures. You get Anakin, you get R2-D2, so this probably has to be a 10 out of 10, even though about that part where the pieces fall off, it has to be a 9 out of 10. But I really like this set, other than that, those two pieces falling off. So anyway, 10 out of 10 for the Naboo Fighter. Next up here, we have Y-Wing and TIE Fighter. I don't really like this set. I don't really like the Y-Wing, but, yeah, just not really a good build for the Y-Wing and Darth Vader's, TIE Fighter. Yeah. So, I'd have to give this a 9 out of 10. Next up, we go down, and we have the Sith Infiltrator. I like this one. It's a 10 out of 10. I like the Sith Infiltrator ship. Probably my favorite Sith flying weapon, I guess if you want to call it. But yeah, you get Darth Maul. He's pretty cool. You get his droids that follow him and go tell him where the heroes are. But yeah, that's pretty cool. You get the Gungans. Next up is the Gungan sub. You get that fish on the side. You get a cool side build. And you get three cool minifigures. 10 out of 10. Next up is the Mos Espa Pod Racer. You get Sebulba's Pod Racer. You get Anakin's Pod Racer. And I don't know who else's Pod Racer you get. But three Pod Racers in one set, I mean, you can't get any better. Automatic 10 out of 10. And that is it. So, yeah, let's get on. Anyway, that is it for today, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. And as always, Fresh Bricks out.